You equally robust about your Labour Party colleague and former leader Jeremy Corbyn addressing a rally, a pro-Palestinian rally on the weekend, where they had placards saying, "Stop doing what Hitler did to you. Zionism is terrorism and Israel is a terrorist state." Should Jeremy Corbyn be addressing that rally, Lisa Nandy?
Well, I don't think that people should be stopped from demonstrating in support of the Palestinian people, just as they shouldn't be stopped from demonstrating in support of Israel, which we saw over the weekend as well. What I think has to happen, though, is any MP that was present at either of those rallies ought to make absolutely crystal clear their opposition to those people who sought to hijack those demonstrations for their own ends. The anti-Semitic imagery at that particular rally that you talked about was absolutely appalling, and it has real world consequences for Jewish people here in the United Kingdom. So I'd expect him and others to make clear their opposition to those people who hijacked that protest.
Anybody would have seen that coming, Lisa Nandy. He shouldn't have gone in the first place, should he, Mr. Corbyn?
Well, look, it's, you know, Jeremy's not currently a Labour MP. It's for him to account for his own actions. What I would say to you, though, is that there are a lot of people here in the United Kingdom who feel very strongly in support of Israel, who feel very strongly in support of Palestine. I would never want to stop them being able to demonstrate that strength of feeling. But what I feel is really, really important is that British Jews and British Muslims, we will not tolerate them being scapegoated or made to take the blame for something that is absolutely nothing to do with them. And the anti-Semitic imagery in particular, you know, those responsible may face criminal sanctions, and in my view, they ought to.
But noting that Mr. Corbyn has had the whip removed, why is he still in the party?
Well, there was a process that was followed where he was suspended from the Labour Party and then readmitted in accordance with the rules. It's not for me as a senior politician to interfere with those rules. That's how we got into this mess in the first place, if you remember, Nick, when the Equality and Human Rights Commission said it was not acceptable for friends or those close to the leadership to try and influence the outcome of decisions. But I have to say, I think Keir Starmer was right to withdraw the whip. As far as I'm aware, Jeremy hasn't apologised for the hurt that he caused to the Jewish community, and until he does, I don't think that he should sit as a Labour MP.